incoming transmission.
This Museum District condo,
1 minute to auto-destruct,
will transport you to a galaxy far, far away.
I've always been interested in science fiction, Star Trek, etc., my whole life.
Jeff Shugart has all the memorabilia, from Star Trek glasses to holiday decorations.
We have a Star Trek Christmas tree.
He's what many would call a Trekkie. But the one person he knew who loved the Borg more.
My son Chase took it to the next level.
The 25-year-old's interests were out of this world.
He knew them all. And he had far surpassed me in Star Trek knowledge at this point.
And he was quick to share that knowledge with friends and total strangers.
He liked to talk to people, liked to listen to people. He made you feel like you were the only person in the room.
Which is why when he was diagnosed with leukemia in 2019, he quickly became one of the VCU Critical Care Center's favorite patients.
He made fast friends with all the nurses, the staff, the transport people, the janitors, the doctors. But he would help them with their problems, you know, talk with them at night, just care about people. You got a
friend in me. Hospital staff even helped Chase film this video.
It was supposed to be a takeoff, the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, the resident patient of critical care.
It's a clip his dad still gets emotional watching because his oldest son didn't get the chance to live long and prosper.
Not expecting it.
In December of 2020, Chase died of cancer complications.
It's not right. It's not the order of things. You sit and wonder, well, what would he be doing today?
Because of the pandemic, the Shugarts weren't able to hold a traditional funeral.
Everybody said, well, when are you going to have a celebration? Well, I can't. And then by the time COVID is over, time has passed.
But Jeff wanted to find a special way to honor and say goodbye to his oldest son.
I just remember hearing about some news item or article about launching ashes into space and then they come right back down to Earth. I thought, well, wait a minute, is that a real thing?
A quick Google search led him to Celestis. It's a company that launches cremated human remains into space, a space burial.
They had the Enterprise flight, which is named after Star Trek, on the Vulcan rocket, which is named after Star Trek, and the Voyager mission, which is named after Star Trek. I'm like, well, I've got to do this.
The Deep Space Voyager mission will launch later this year from Cape Canaveral, Florida.
It's deep space. It's past the moon. It's between the moon and Mars, so to speak. And it'll just be there forever.
Chase's remains will be put into a capsule, joining an eclectic crew, the remains and mind files of more than 200 others, including Star Trek creator Gene Roddenberry and some original cast members.
He would be thrilled to know that he was up there with Scotty and Dr. McCoy and Lieutenant Uhura.
Even DNA from Presidents John F. Kennedy, Dwight Eisenhower, and George Washington will boldly go where no man has gone before.
It's a big deal. I truly believe he will be up there just chatting with everybody forever and never get tired of it.
Here on Earth, Shugart still has physical reminders of his son everywhere.
He's there with the Borg and Star Trek.
He enjoys imagining the possibilities of his new journey in space.
To think that some civilization may find this and go, look at these. These are pretty nice people. I guess planet Earth was a pretty nice place, you know?
But for now, when he's missing his favorite Trekkie.
Yep, there I see him.
He can look to the stars.
It's morphin' time, yeah.